Morning. Okay. It's not such a somber day after all, so I think we can be slightly more relaxed about what we're going to do the whole day. We've got a full day to spend here, but it's a pleasure to be back with this Chennai Retail Summit to the fraternity. I thought this is also an occasion where some people had actually come back and said, listen, we are very new to Retailers Association of India. And over the last few days, I've been hearing what are the various things that you really do. So that gave me a thought that maybe we should explain a bit about Retailers Association, people who are uninitiated. And those who are initiated to this may get some clue from here which could help them in their business, hopefully. First and foremost, thank you to the entire regional committee to make this really happen. Things like this cannot happen unless various members put their shoulder to the wheel and get an association moving. And after all, Retailers Association is an association of members created by members, and that's the beauty of what we are all about. I'll make it quick because I know we are running behind time. There are three focus areas for RAI. Beyond that, we really don't do much. So we do a whole lot on advocacy. So we work with governments and semi-government bodies. We work along with the media in various fronts. And we also have a magazine called Storai. We do collaboration with various organizations globally to try and bring in some best practices from across the world into the Indian context. We work secondly on a whole lot on talent development. And talent development is crucial to make sure that we have enough people in the industry to run the business. I would dare say that while we are doing a whole lot, we can from various studies really make out that the need to really develop more talent is dramatically more than what we've done so far. So it only means that the market size is larger, but it also shows that each one of you can do your bit to help develop talent in the industry. The specialist programs or verticals is something that we do. We also create some research papers, advisory papers, etc., and I'll take you through that very fast. We do events like this, and like Mr. Harris told you, the thought process is to bring a lot of you together to discuss various things that really is there in the business and to try and help. If each one of you go back with at least two new ideas to run your business in a slightly better form, I think our day is made. After all, it's few ideas and the ability to convert that ideas into action that can get our business going. We do various industry meets. We also are in the process of creating a service provider database, but within RAI, we've got a few people available with us and a whole lot of associate members with us who provide service. I've given the main things here, so I'll just continue with this for lack of time. On the advocacy initiative, the largest thing that we've been trying to do over the last few years, and that's something that that Harris talked about in a slight form, is to create a policy for retail. All of us know that retail does not come under one ministry. It's at one time being governed with rules from the labor department. Sometimes the rules are getting governed by the agriculture ministry, some rules from the consumer affairs ministry, some rules from the commerce ministry. I think the worry has always been, how do we get this together? We've been drum beating on this to various states. We've been drum beating on this at the central level. Hopefully, at some point, somebody will take this up and run, either a state or a center. But this is the only way to really work on this. I do have to say that we are seeing lots more hopes now with the new government in the center. So hopefully there should be some kind of a policy guideline coming for retail and internal trade. There are various things that we've done on service tax on rental. Some of you actually joined during the time when we created this whole thought process. Just to benefit of some of the retailers, it's not as if we've left the case down under. As late as yesterday, we had a big call on the service tax issue. We are still trying to tackle this from two ends, one from the judiciary end and the other from the advocacy end, where we are going and talking to the revenue ministers, to the revenue secretary, to the government at the center, to try and help us on the one hand to give us a moratorium of some kind or an abatement of some kind, and on the other to help us with the previous history. And all these issues around retrospective tax can hopefully help us. So we hope things will change, but I think it's not for lack of efforts from overall the industry so far. Plastic bags, some of you know, I mean, it's helped. We know that members of REI used to be consuming as much as 2,100 tons of plastic covers every month. And after this initiative of charging for plastic covers, the consumption came down to 900 metric tons per month. On the one hand, the consumption has come down. On the other hand, customers are not throwing the plastic covers away at random, at least the ones that are issued by our members, because these are ones with higher GSM. And I think we've done our bit to ecology, and we've also done our bit to the retailers in some form, because retailers got some money back. It's not like it made any big profit thing for them, but they reduced their expenses. The Legal Metrology Act, we know that it's Package Commodities Act is a big worry, and 2 weeks before, we had a very serious amount of meetings with the Legal Metrology, with the Consumer Affairs Ministry. Hopefully, you should change this. You should see a big change in the Legal Metrology Act in the next 1 month's time, because the current government and their people are able to understand the real issues behind it. They have promised that we had given them 8 points from us, including telling we don't want all our directors to be hauled up for lack of label, which is, would have happened inadvertently, for telling if we can go back to the manufacturer and for a fault of the manufacturer, why are you coming to the retailers, to ask them to give us a method wherein if we are giving them the basic things, like, you know, on television, we had cases wherein television was being displayed in centimeters and in inches, and we were slapped